can't even rock them shoes if it don't got a comma on the price tag, you know. I mean, but then again, who looks at the price tag, you know?
Oh, yeah, we in this bitch. In this bitch.
Ooh, child. Oh, my gosh, I'm shouting and I'm so fucking sick. You know, this is a long-awaited video. I feel like I haven't seen you guys in fucking ages. Like, I'm literally so sorry, but I'm getting ready to go to the nail shop now. Oh, fuck, I meant to put it on the actual hair, Shan. Yeah, so basically, this video is kind of like, where has Nellszofficial been? I feel like I've done like three fucking videos of this same topic. It's because I keep disappearing. I'm just trying to get this all in formation, really. I mean, I don't actually use mousse on my hair. And I don't want it like to look like a wet shabba dog. I like it to be just like this, bushy. Did they stay? Yeah, so ski. They stayed. Fabulous. Anyway, guys. Right, hi my babies. Hi. I feel like I haven't seen you guys, as I said, in forever. Honestly, yeah, so let me just talk to you guys of what the fuck's been happening. Also going to get a lash infill today. I was gonna do this video tomorrow when everything's done, but I'm working tomorrow and then I'm going out straight after, so I ain't gonna have the time. And plus, I wanna drop this video ASAP. But yeah, cool. So what's been going on with me, as you guys probably have all been wondering, to be fair, or even if you ain't, I'm gonna tell you anyway. Don't fucking care, mate. It's my channel. I could talk if I want. What has actually been going on with me? I feel like a lot and then nothing has been going on. Like, it's just so weird. So at the start of the year, I was vlogging. So when did I stop vlogging? When was my last vlog? You can kind of tell like when I'm gonna ghost, because like I start posting like just anything. So I think the last vlog was just like anything to nothing. Yeah, like I think we all can fucking agree with that. But yeah, so then after, I just became like, okay, cool. So one incident actually happened in my life where it was just like, okay, so I caught the big C. The big C, guys, I caught COVID-19. And when I tell you, it was the most horrific experience of my fucking life. I'm not even joking. I mean, I joke around a lot, but I'm not joking right now. Because, wow, that was quite sexy. I mean, do you want us to listen or do you want us to... God, she bodied this. Yeah, so I caught COVID-19. I caught it actually at a party, which was so dumb. So I caught it at a party, and then this was my story. So literally, I went to work, and then obviously you guys know I work in a hospital. So I went to work. I was on a night shift. My back really started killing me. Like, it started feeling heavy. Like, everything was like a task. Like, I just started feeling tired. Cool. So that was probably about 8:30. Around 10 o'clock, I went to go do, like, all my duties that I normally do at 10 o'clock when I'm on a night shift. And then, like, I started feeling mad. What did I feel, cold or hot? I think I felt hot. Yeah, so I felt really hot, like, burning hot, innit? So I was thinking, nah. And I checked my forehead, and it was like, oh my gosh, you're burning, sort of thing. So then I thought to myself, okay, so let me check my temperature. But whereas like I was laughing and joking, because like I'm a free spirit, innit? Like, you guys can tell this. So it's a thing where it was like, oh my gosh, like, why do I feel like this, sort of thing? Like, I was at work still busting jokes, whatever, cool. But then it's like I still had medical issues wrong with me, clearly. So cool. I then done my own temperature. So I took my own temperature because I thought to myself, if I now ask, obviously the colleague that I'm on work with, she's gonna be like, what the fuck? Because you've literally been busting jokes. Like, you're fine, innit? So I thought, let me check it myself. If it's nothing, I won't mention it. When I checked my temperature, it was 37.4. So that's like borderline, innit? That's kind of like, so on a chart, we have like clear, then we have yellow, and then we have red. The 37.4 was yellow. So I thought to myself, okay. So it was not average. No problem, that was at 10 o'clock. After that, I just started feeling tired, feeling like my head, I had a headache. It was pounding. Like, I couldn't focus on nothing. This was probably about 12:45 in the morning. I'm like to my colleague, nah, can you check my temperature? I don't feel well. She looked at me like, bitch, like, you trying to go home and leave me? Like, she proper looked at me like, not today. And I was thinking, nah, bro, because you don't even know, at 10 o'clock I was already on borderline and now I'm feeling like death. So you need to check my temperature. Seriously, all seriousness, please check my temperature. She checked my temperature. It was 38.6, as in my body had got to 38.6 temperature, bro. As in, like, that was my temperature, like breathing temperature, as in like a volcano. So she looked at me like, what the fuck? Like, she's looking at me like, bro, do you do just like, how the fuck, like, could you be laughing and joking? Now your temperature has spiked and you need to go home. Long story short, they ordered me a cab home and I came home. I got home around, I probably left around 2, but because the cabs were taking so long to, like, it was 2 in the morning, and I think it was on like a Wednesday. It was on a Wednesday, so I was just thinking, sorry guys, I keep looking at time because I don't want to miss my appointment for you guys. But yeah, so I just kept thinking to myself, oh my gosh, like I'm gonna die, innit? Like, how the hell do I have COVID, sort of thing? Then now I have gone home, whatever, cool. I posted on my private story that, yeah, I got sent home. Obviously no one really cares, like, no one really cares. So then, cool, I've gone to sleep now, I've woken up. But at work, they're advising me, do a test before you come back to work, innit? Because it's health and safety, innit? Cool. But I was just thinking, no, it can't be that, like, it can't be COVID sort of thing. Because when I woke up the next day, I wasn't feeling hot. Oh, this is what happened. So I must have woke up at, like, I got home at 3 and I woke up at 6. Obviously, because my body clock is fucked, innit? So cool. Yeah, so my body clock is fucked. So I woke up at 6. I've gone to my room. I've gone to the bathroom. Gone to the toilet, sorry. And then come back. I check my phone naturally. And as I've gone onto Snapchat, you know, like, I wasn't even trying to do a video of myself, sort of thing. But like, I must have tapped my lip. And I remember I couldn't feel my lip, innit? Like, it was just mad swollen. So I was thinking to myself, what the fuck? So I've looked on Snapchat and my lips look like this. Cool. So yeah, my lips were done for. Like, honestly, they were done for. So I just thought to myself, what the fuck, like, that doesn't make no sense. Like, why am I, like, I was now thinking that I had an allergic reaction, for fuck's sake. So I thought I had an allergic reaction. Then the Thursday, I didn't go anywhere. I didn't even go to the test center to do a test because I was done. Like, I was dying almost. So next day now, Friday, I've woken up, my lips have kind of gone down a bit, but then I'm just like passing out, I'm feeling sick, like, I'm just feeling faint, everything cool. So I've called B, then she's like, what's happening? And then I'm like, I'm gonna go in the shower because I'm getting ready to go to the hospital because I don't feel well in it. Like, I'm not even exaggerating, I don't feel well. She was like, cool, I'm gonna order you a cab. She ordered me a cab. And you know that heat wave, that mini heat wave that we had in like end of July to coming into August, that was literally the time I had COVID, sort of thing. So it was like, I was in the cab and it was so hot, and I remember it being so hot and I was thinking, bro, I'm gonna pass out in the cab. I think I did pass out in the cab, if I'm honest, because I remember waking up and was outside the hospital. But obviously all these times I didn't know it was COVID, innit? Because when I was younger, I used to get admitted into hospital for like little things like dehydration and stuff like that, innit? So I just thought it was that. Sorry, me talking so much is really hurting my throat now. Like, I'm even thinking that I have it now again. So yeah, so I remember going to the hospital, whatever, cool. I've gone to the reception now and then I've told her like what's happening with me, and she's like, read this thing and do you feel like you have any of these symptoms? But at the time I didn't have none of this. The only symptom I had from COVID related was literally the high temperature, and on that day that I went to the thing, I didn't really feel as hot on that day in it that I was when I was at work, sort of thing. Cool. Now so then that happened, whatever, cool. And then what else happened? Yeah, so then she was like, all right, cool, take a seat. I went in there, whatever. From when I sat down, he said that you don't look well. I thought, okay, well, that's the first acknowledgement that I need. Yeah, I don't feel well, thanks Dr. Einstein. He's like, you don't look well, let me do your temperature. So my temperature was 36.7, so it was now on a red. So they said, yeah, we're gonna have to admit you, this, that and the other. All these times I'm not thinking it's COVID. Da-da-da. When I got home at 3 o'clock in the morning from home, I did do a COVID test, that, you know, like them rapid ones, the little stick things, and it come back negative. So Now that they've said to me, oh yeah, you need to be admitted, whatever, cool. They've taken me to a bay and then they said, have you done a COVID test? And I said, yeah, I done it on Wednesday and it showed up negative. So then they was like, okay, let's take your temperature again. So it went up again from 37.6 to, I think it went up to 38.2. Yeah, 38.2. So they're now looking at me thinking, well, if it's not COVID, then what the fuck is it? Because you've just come from the waiting room to the back and your temperature has risen again. So they was like, let's just do a COVID test for keepsake. I said, okay, cool. Done a COVID test. They all came in ballied up, as in, bro, they came up, masked up, everything, gloves, da-da-da-da-da. And obviously, because I work in a hospital, I know what time it is from when I'm seeing them type of people. So I'm thinking, what's going on? Like, I ain't got COVID sort of thing. So then they was like, okay, well, Chanel, we have to move you to isolation bay because you have COVID. I said, I have what? I'm thinking now, I've just come from the waiting room to this back room and you're telling me that I've caught COVID. But obviously, like, I'm proper being arrogant now. I'm thinking to myself, like, how the fuck can I have COVID? They have no science, it's just this, that. So come to realise now. So yeah, I've gone to the back now. I've called my mom. I've said, bro, like, I'm not even allowed no visitors, this, that and the other. Bro, they've put me on a ward with big, like, God forbid, half dying dead people. Like, what the fuck?
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
Bro. They've put me on a ward where it's like bare old people, ventilators, masked up. They can't even talk. Like, and I'm thinking, well, if I didn't have COVID from the waiting room to here, I definitely have it now, bro. I'm infested. So cool. I'm now calling everyone. Like, I'm like, bro, like, I'm gonna die. Like, I'm definitely going to die. Cool. So then they've put me on the drip. I'm thinking, bro, what the fuck is happening? Like, why am I on the drip? Like, they're telling me that I need fluids, I need this, I need oxygen, I need air. Like, they're telling me, bow, bow, nigga. Like, you're done.
Done.
Like, I'm here thinking, wow, like, is this an act sort of thing? Like, they're putting me on the drip, but they're thinking that they're helping me, but they're not. Like, they're trying to end me off, bro. The doctors come and said, I've never seen a girl your age this sick from COVID. Da-da-da-da-da. He's telling me all the things, like, all the things. And I'm just thinking, God, like, why me? So in the midst of it, let me tell you guys the tea. I know you guys want to know about my love life. So in the midst of COVID, me and that one was going through it, innit? I remember the day I found out I had COVID was the day he wanted to end me. He said, well, yeah, he basically ended it. He was just like, yeah, like, it's... I think the last thing I said to him, because it was already ending, I'm not gonna lie, it was already ending. And then the last thing he said to me on that day was, yeah, like, we ain't doing this no more. Like, it's not that no more. Huh? So of course I'm being admitted into hospital now. It looks like I'm trying to fucking commit suicide, bro. Like, when I left you, you was fine. Now and I'm not with you no more. This bitch has admitted herself into fucking Morsley, mate. So I know his part, he's probably thinking, this bitch is crazy. So I'm now in a dying bed. I put on my private story, like, bro, anyone that calls me dramatic again is getting shot, because now, bro, they're killing me. If I weren't dramatic, they're killing me.
They trying to kill me up in this bitch.
Nada. No Nellszofficial. Huh? She done. Like, she's done. That was that now. I've stayed in a hospital. Whatever, cool. Then the doctors told me, oh, you're improving. Duh, 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 duh. You can come out. I said, thank the heavens. Because I was thinking to myself, people that go in, it do go down. Like, you know that vine, yeah? And it's like, it don't go down, it do. Like, it's like I was telling the nurse, bro, these niggas die in this space. They was like,
no, it don't,
it do go down.
Oh.
I was like, it do. So yeah, that was it. So then after that whole COVID thing, I come off snap and I come off everything, because I was just thinking, fuck that, bro. I don't want to see no one's life if my life ain't straight. And the thing is, yeah, it's like, I only thought this because of my health. Like, when the doctor told me he hasn't seen no one this age be so sick, I was thinking to myself, wow, because for a doctor to say that, bro, obviously he could have been saying that, but for him to even say that, like, there's so many words you can say to someone, but you've just told me that. Like, have some fucking respect. So it was a thing, like, wow, like, I can't believe that my mom was telling me that sort of thing. So I was just like, fuck this, like, fuck all social media. I don't want to be on nothing. I don't want no one to know my life. If you ain't got my number, then we won't talk sort of thing. So obviously, I was in isolation for 10 days. It was hellhole. Like, the symptoms that I had, like, all in my in my nose, everything was just disgusting. I don't wish it on no one. But after I came out of isolation, I took my mum out to eat because obviously she had been in isolation with me, sort of thing. So it was like, oh, you know what? Like, first day out, mum's either, come on, let's go pop bottles. I took a duck and waffle. Obviously, you don't know that's my favourite. If you have it on Snap and Insta and that, that's my favourite, innit? So I was like, cool, like, let me take my favourite person to my favourite spot. Favorites. Yeah, we've got stuck and waffle, had a nice evening, whatever, cool. And after COVID, like after lockdown, I was just back to getting my money. Like, it sounds so crazy me saying this because I'm a girl, but I just wanted to get back to my money. Obviously, like, we all have sick pay and that, but you know, like, just like, money's not a material thing to me, it's like a mindset. Do you get it? So it's like, I want to get back on my grind, I want to get back on my bullshit. So it's like, I was gonna do this COVID story as soon as I come out of lockdown, but whereas I was just like, bro, I need to focus on one thing, and that was just like work, getting back into a routine, like getting back to doing stuff. Like, even I was catting to go back to the gym because it was just like, wow, like, bro, the amount of weight I lost was ridiculous, guys. Honestly, it was ridiculous. But I just thought to myself, do you know what? I know what I need to do to gain the weight back. Like, it's not like all my days, like, I don't know nothing. Da, 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 da. I had a game plan. I had the plan.
And I just needed the platform.
Right. I had the plan, but I just need the platform. So, yeah, it was a thing like that, sort of thing. Yeah, so then after that, love life-wise, me and him obviously got back together, whatever, cool. And then it was a thing where it was, when I say go back together, guys, it was never a relationship, like, because he's probably gonna watch this and think, this girl is crazy. Nah, bro, I'm not claiming you, but we were something in it, period. Yeah, that's what it was. Da-da-da-da. So life started picking up again. I got back into the routine, I was working, I was going gym, da-da-da-da-da. And then it was just a thing where it's like, I still have this very preserved mindset. Even now, like, I don't really snap, I don't really post, because it's just like, I just looked at everything as bullshit. Like, it's not really for anyone to know. But then I kind of like lost myself, and I just thought to myself, rah, like, what am I actually doing? Like, you're forgetting your whole purpose. You can be preserved, but you're forgetting your purpose, bro. You're a fucking YouTuber. Period.
Period.
I need to end this video, guys, because I really need to go. So, in terms of content wise, I will be posting. Y'all know I got that new banner, that new intro, nigga. We rebranding. Yeah, so cool. So in terms of YouTube wise, I'm gonna be posting more. Hopefully I get more socially active as well. Like, I actually post my looks, because I've been killing shit. Like, they be playing with my name like I won't kill a bitch.
They be hating, throwing shade like I ain't killing shit.
So, yeah, that's it really, guys. I promise to be, I can guarantee that I'm gonna stay. Even if I don't post and I go ghosting, gonna be for a reason. Literally. So yeah, hopefully more vlogs, more pranks, more, I don't want to say get to know me, but just like more fun shit in it. Like, hopefully I get a couple collabs as well. I'm getting my camera fixed soon, so use like that, you guys won't have to deal with this shit quality. But yeah, thank you for being patient. Remember to like, comment and subscribe, and I shall see y'all hoes in December.